Hello and welcome to Azure Wala YouTube channel. We are in part 16 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. Let's go to question number 39. You have an Azure Active Directory tenant named contoso.com. You have a CSV file that contains the names and email addresses of 500 external users. You need to create a guest user account in contoso.com for each of 500 external users. So for this question, there are several different solutions are available over the internet, and I have compiled them all together so we can see which are the correct answers. So solution first, you create a PowerShell script that runs the new Azure AD MS invitation commandlet for each external user. So solution one is that PowerShell script that runs this command new Azure AD MS invitation, and this command is basically for inviting external users to Active Directory, and the parameters are being passed like a name and emails addresses of 500 external users is sufficient to conduct the job. So this is meeting our requirement. Let's see the next solution. From Azure Active Directory in Azure portal, you use the bulk create user operation. So a bulk create option is available in Active Directory in Azure portal, but that is for Active Directory user, or so therefore this command will not be applicable for external user. Let's see a next solution. From Azure AD in the Azure portal, you use the bulk invite user operation. At the first glance, it looks like this solution will work, because bulk invite is for external user in Active Directory to invite in bulk, but there is a glitch that the name and email only provided in the CSV file, but in this case there should be a redirect URL which is mandatory, should be included. If that is not included, it is not going to work. That's why bulk invite is not going to work in this case, since we do not have a redirect URL included in the CSV file. For solution, you create a PowerShell script that runs the new Azure AD user. That is again limited for Active Directory user, not for external. Therefore this solution will also not work. So over the internet you will find a question with the different solutions, and I have clubbed all this together, so it will be helpful to remember each and every option which is going to be in exam. Let's move to question number 40. Most probably this question will not be appearing in the exam, but still we'll just prepare, since Microsoft recently announced an article saying that no new cluster can be created with Azure Active Directory integration. All Azure Active Directory integration AKS clusters will be migrated to AKS managed Azure Active Directory automatically starting from August 1st 2023, and AKS has a new improved AKS managed active and directory experience that doesn't require you to manage the server or client applications. But still quickly we'll go through this question. You have an Azure subscription that contains an Azure Active Directory tenant named contoso.com and Azure Kubernetes Services cluster named AKS1. An administrator reports that she is unable to grant access to AKS1 to the users in contoso.com. You need to ensure that access to AKS1 can be granted to the contoso.com users. What should you do first? What should we do first in this case? Because answer is very obvious here, that from Contoset.com we need to create OAuth2 authorization endpoint. The endpoint will allow users in tenant to authenticate and obtain an access token which can be used to access the Kubernetes API server. Therefore, the first step is create an OAuth2 authorization endpoint. Other options: option A, modify the organization relationship, is not related to granting the access to AKS, so that is not applicable. Option C, recreating AKS 1 is not necessary as issue is related to user access, not with the AKS. From AKS 1, create a namespace, that is also not required, that has nothing to do with the granting access, so that is not going to work. So I hope this video was informative for you. So please do like, subscribe and press the bell notification icon, and also share with your friends. See you in next video. Thank you.